This video brought to you by Gamefly. Go to gameflyoffered.com/halocanon for a 30-day free trial. Stick around to the end for more details. Hey there, Canonites. Welcome back to Halo Canon. Today I have some very special footage to share with y'all that I captured at Gen Con over in Indiana this past weekend. Spartan Games was there. They were showing off Halo Ground Command and Fleet Battles in a smaller regard, and you know, some of their other franchises and whatnot. But obviously the focus for me and for you guys would have been Ground Command. So there's some nice footage. Some of it's hard to hear at some points. I tried to clean up the audio as best I could. You know, as they go into a lot of there's a lot of details that they go over at various points. What the starter kit's going to come with, what kind of scenarios they're looking at, both at launch, which is actually, there's not going to be a campaign book, sadly, but there will be scenarios that they release online later on and going forward. So, yeah, sit back and enjoy. Oh, and if you're wearing headphones, heads up. Unfortunately, one thing I could not fix is that my voice is very fucking loud. So, yeah, don't say I didn't warn you.
Well, there she is, Spartan Games. And here we are, Halo Ground Command.
Target the legs and try and collapse it. You can target the bits of it. You can even drop a Spartan on top of the dice and take it to the level. I mean, it's not... It's one of those things it's in that kind of a narrative of the game. It's not a, you know, you're not concerned about a tournament. They're, hey, I brought my scarab, you know. or more like, hey, I brought my scarab. It's sort of a, you know, if you're a fan and you love the game, it's the sort of thing you add on because of that. So, because it's just, yeah.
It's one of those luxury pieces to be more narrative than actual tournament.
Yeah, it's exactly. You know, it seems like, you know, it's kind of,
I can't wait to see that thing. That's especially to a proper scale with everything else, because the game's always, oh really?
Yeah. Oh, so that's a pelican actual size.
Fingers for reference.
Enjoy the show.
Oh god. I pre-ordered the base set, but I cannot afford these guys just yet.
Yeah.
But I want to.
That's a great thing is that you get the cardboard tokens.
Yeah.
You'll come with it, and then there's the acrylic deluxe token blister that has them all in nice acrylic, and so because they're such a core part of the game, you could still have them and play with them. You don't need to buy the...
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Model.
I've seen like the alternative.
Just, if you want it.
I definitely want it. I mean...
It's beautiful,
yeah,
isn't it?
I'm a kid.
What you're not seeing over there as well is that we've actually... towards the end of this month when we release them, is we've got two little add-on kits that people can get. That can suspend a ghost or suspend a scorpion there.
Very nice.
And on this guy here, we haven't quite fully figured out the attachment yet, but this thing...
Yeah, because the game just has it floating there.
This thing can carry a couple of ghosts at the back.
Yeah.
Out of race. So we know how to attach the ghost. The race a little bit more tricky for us.
Oh yeah, I bet. That's but we've got to be the easiest
thing. We've got a version of that which is closed up as well, so we'll do... It'll probably be... The problem with that is that it's one of those things where you guys will have to make a conscious decision with if you want it, because once you've attached it, it's there.
Yeah.
And it's, you can actually unhook the water. It's there's kind of a sliding mechanic that you got like a hook, and you take the gun off. We supply it with anyone. And the clips go under that bar there.
Yeah.
So it actually suspends under the water.
Yeah.
Under that. But you can actually take...
Pretty game accurate in that case, too.
Yeah. Tell them the story about the thumbs. Go on.
They tried submitting the infantry guys without thumbs because they're so small the detail wouldn't show up.
Yeah.
Looking at it like, no, we need to have thumbs on that. So four infantry figures go back and have their thumbs.
Oh, wow.
Not even looking at one of the millimeters.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow, that is...
My
back on then the Spartan that is back. That was good. I missed that completely. That was, there's about a 1.5 mil bit of detail on the Spartan 3's armour. It's Bismuth Spine. He's got it now. Because I sent the Spartan and then he went, now take the Spartan away and do it again. And I was like, really? And they were like, yeah. And I'm like, okay. So we went away and did it. I think it was something to do with his feet as well, wasn't it?
Yeah, he's missing his ankle armor, so it looked like he had high waters on. You know, Spartan capris. So like, let's fix that a little bit.
Yeah, he's got it now.
I would admittedly love to see a Spartan capris. I think that would be a fantastic little addition to the canon.
Where'd you get that shirt?
Jinx.com.
Awesome. Do you know if you guys played around with different model sizes before settling on the 1.5 liters?
What it really came down to is you look at.
So we're going to look around with Spartans killing things.
Doing what Spartans do best.
Like, what do you want to have in a Halo game? Yeah. And like 28 mil is, you know, for your first person shooter, very analogous to the FPS, would be that great match. But then when you start getting into a Mongoose, this would be easy. Warthogs get to be a little bit bigger. A 28 mil Scorpion gets to be huge. Oh, yeah. And then you start scaling it. And when you play Halo, there's not a lot of vehicles at the same size. And so you've got like a Mongoose and you've got a Ghost. Yeah. And so we start figuring out, like, what do we want to play with? Well, what is it going to take to get a Pelican on the table? Mm-hmm. And so you start that at the high end and you're like, well, a Pelican is actually reasonable at 15 mil. And so we also look at 10 and we look at 6, but then at the small scale, you start to lose the details and the figures. And you're like, well, no, because you still figures are important in Halo. We want to be able to see the weapons. So where do we bring that back up? And it's just that balancing act to get everything that you get in Halo to fit nicely on the table.
And from what I've heard, it's also, you guys are considering doing a Scarab at some point in the future.
Yeah, that's just one of the dreams. It's one of his crazy ideas. Make it, you know, maybe for a Gen Con show or something.
Also kind of like the CSO for fleet battles.
Yeah, and at scale, it'd be about a 24-inch square base.
I'd buy it. I'd drop a grand on that. I'll let you know. And I know plenty of fans that would.
You'll make it happen.
I'll drop a grand on a Scarab.
Sorry?
I'll drop a grand on a Scarab if that ever came to me.
I only reckon maximum $450, $500.
Even better. There we go.
We're thinking we'll be shooting for about $350, $400. It is a big kit.
Oh, yeah. Because I imagine, because years back they had the Action Clicks Halo line, I imagine it's probably a similar scale to that. I think this is a little smaller scale than the Action Clicks were. But. Yeah, even then it would still be massive.
It's bad enough for he's having to make thousands of those bloody Pelicans and things. because they're not easy kids to get.
Oh, I bet. It's because they're
my attitude to this, right? Are you a structural engineer?
Yeah. No. Not even.
I'm a magician with green stuff.
So you'll have like.
What?
A magician with green stuff. You know that? Colleague?
Oh, no. I wish.
Arrogant. So,
but I have some basic understanding of it.
Surely if I sell you a model kit, right?
Uh-huh.
When you get it out of the box and you put it together, you shouldn't be stood there going, what the hell is this? You should still own all the skin on your hand, because you haven't had to heat bend the resin in water, because when it got you, it did that, and it's supposed to be that. So we don't make model kits like that. We make model kits that go together. That's this man. He does my stuff.
Wow.
And that's...
Spaceships are great.
Nice and organic.
So the attitude is... You know,
oh, it's spent? Well, that's what it's supposed to be.
Yeah, build it properly. Respect your customers. Simple as that. Now, it might take you a while to build a Scarab because they're going to be freaking complicated.
I will happily drop a weekend building that thing because...
The thing is with that sort of stuff, it's they're iconic in the game, you know.
Yeah.
I'm only building it because 343 told me I would be able to do it. And I like to prove them wrong.
I would love you to prove them wrong, too.
No, I will be. I'm actually taking one to Seattle in October to give to them.
Oh, nice.
I'm making it and painting it and taking it to Seattle.
Very nice.
And hopefully they'll put it in the Halo Museum.
Oh, I bet they will.
And then next year, I don't know exactly when it'll be out, but you're probably looking. We've got a really, these guys have got like a 3-year release for this. And so I hope that I've got it out by the middle of next year. Because that gives the game plenty of time.
That'll give me plenty of time to recover my finances.
So
the big one.
But yeah, no, it'll be good. You know, we might put it up, you know, we might be able to. I think
we also have the spaceships.
Some of these big models we can make available at the shop, but we can't put the distribution. As soon as we implement the distribution, the price goes up. But we can do that like 20% in stores, so shops can special order.
Right.
Shop can make 20% in the special order.
Yeah, you can come in and take a look.
But we just can't put it in the distribution because you end up with like a Pelican's $95, right? Which I think is a bloody good price for what it is. If it's a distribution, it would have to be like $195. And then it's silly. It's interesting. It's complicated, but also, not everybody wants these things.
Yeah.
When they see them, it's really funny. They almost start drooling at the corner of their mouth. It's like, oh my god,
Because I do videos on YouTube covering Halo specifically, so when all that was announced, especially with Brown Command, comments blowing up. Like, it's the smallest channel, but you know what? It got a lot of views because everybody I talked to, excited beyond belief for this.
With Rick probably explained, we picked 15 mil because it's a mass battle game. I mean, I'd have loved to have done 28 mil as well, but to be honest with you, if you want 28 mil, play the video.
Yeah.
I mean, that doesn't mean that we won't do stuff in the future on that covers things, but, you know, we're such a lucky company because, you know, I sent them an email and said, I would really love to do Halo. And I prepared myself for them to say, hey guys, thanks, but go with. So when they actually said, we know you, where do you play your games? They knew just told me the price now. And I was like, really? And they were like, yeah. So I was like,
Well, I mean, it's Spartan Games. How could 343 not play a Spartan game? It's a match made in heaven.
Yeah, and it was funny. Well, you know, then our name of our company, Navy, didn't get us the license.
Yeah.
Because some of the management thought we were trying to cash in on Halo.
God.
My company's named after the Greek dudes, not your dudes.
Well, our dudes are named after the Greek dudes too. We did it first, come on.
Anyway, when they said yes, I remember my wife, Frances, said to me, okay, what now? And I was like, I really don't know. I said, because I had got myself ready for the rejection. So I said, I had ready myself for the yes.
That was the one outcome.
I didn't expect it anyway. But they were fucking too much. I'm not gonna sell it to him. I'm not gonna say how much they're cool. I think I'd be wrong.
Ears burning red.
Yeah,
I know.
I was going to say in front of you, Mel.
Uh-huh.
I was actually about to say how cool it is that you guys have been with us on this date, and it's all games, for God's sake. So it's really easy to build a war game for Halo, because we're surrounded by games. It's like, they
want to do all day. Play stuff.
I'm going to make games.
And he can never tell people this, but I'm probably as cool as a slice of shit. No, I'm probably the biggest pain in the butt.
Yes.
I'm a bit like the
There's a whole yin and yang. I love him. Most of the time.
I'm like the child. You know, the one that says, can I have? And I've got a new server putting in our building now with all this security deposit. And I've got all of this Halo asset on it. I've probably got almost like half the game. I'm almost close to reach. The voice is going again. No, it's really funny. It's been a journey in a half, and it's just starting. Especially with this thing. This is going to be... it's great. Have you had the game of it yet? You should try it out, man. Do you like it?
I'm still working on Planetfall.
Yeah.
Can't talk bad about your first child.
There's bits in Planetfall that I wouldn't have added to Planetfall, but it was Derek's project and I let him run with it. The biggest bit for me is I'm going to rewrite the air stuff because the air on the CGB doesn't work very well. And what we should do is, and make Derek do it, whether he likes it or loves it, we'll do it. And all I want to do is, a bit like a Discovery, I want to put two height levels in. I want to put a ground attack high level. I'm going to put a dogfight on your feet. And then, if you're in ground attack, you can't get shot.
How big an actual scale in a video game, you don't really get a sense of how big everything is around you. So, you know, there's your little Spartan. That's how big the Pelican is.
Okay.
And then over at the War Store booth, just to the right of Great Fox Games, we're doing demos. And we have a prototype of one of those out, so you can actually see how big it is, all physically painted up.
Where?
Just to the right of Great Fox Games. Yeah, they're all unpainted reds. It's your classic war game, build and paint and play.
Right at the War Store booth.
I'm curious if. Regarding the Spartans specifically, is there within the scenarios do they have a team name, like a specific Spartan team name?
No, just the generic at this in the starter box.
Okay.
Because so in Reach, you came in as like Noble Six, which is like any Spartan. Yeah. That's what we are. It's, you know, in the narratively, he is a generic Spartan fighting against the Covenant, one part of the invasion.
Okay.
Later, as the game develops through the heroic characters and through the commander cards, we can get more of the narrative stuff to actually introduce named Spartans and characters.
Yeah. Yeah, because I know that's what, at least in the lore community, Halo's looking forward to, is they want to see, as we know, there's these other Spartan teams, and there's this conflict between Halo Reach and the Fall of Reach novel, and yeah, you guys did a great job with fleet battles and kind of closing some gaps, so we're looking forward to something similar, even on a small scale.
We have the same team, Kenneth on the franchise team,
he's
writing a bunch of that stories, Grim Brother Jeff,
I actually know him pretty well. I'm going to get to meet him in September at PAX.
He's a lovely guy.
I've had nothing but good times talking to him, so I'm looking forward to that.
Both of those guys are working with Spartan and the stuff that we do. Everything that is made is all canon. It's all approved. It all fits in. They publish some of the fiction to help weave all that in, so we get that really tight, cohesive universe.
Yeah. I absolutely can't wait for this guy to arrive at my door, so pleasure talking with you. Thank you. I can't wait to see the rest of it comes out. Cause I'm so excited.
Enjoy the show.
Oh, definitely.
Check out those full details.
We actually were talking about last night. Just says, if you bring a set back, I'll play it with you.
What is this? Puna class. This is a huge, a lot bigger than I expected, but I guess it actually makes sense. There's the Orion. Oh.
So I force you back.
Alright.
And that's it.
Alright.
So what we've done so far, we've learned how to move, we've learned how to shoot, we've learned all about reaction, we've learned melee.
Yep.
That's it. Then what you're doing is layering all that together, interlocking fire lanes, bringing in pelicans, bringing in phantoms and spirits, doing all those things and trying to engage your opponent based upon objectives that are on the table. You might be trying to do an assassinate mission. Assuming that was an assassinate mission, if one of us loses their officer, that's it, game. So sending the Spartan up in front may be a bit of a risk in that case. Whereas, of course, there may be one which is straight kill in this mission, is taking hold here.
Okay.
So, if I wasn't such a doofus and hadn't moved over, perhaps I should have moved into the building and held it that way. And that's it, you learned it all. So you see how the damage application works, you see how the gunning works. It's pretty straightforward.
Yeah.
It's just the rolling of dice and knowing what you're trying to achieve on the tabletop. The final thing to bear in mind are these dice. These dice allow you, this represents you.
Okay.
You're a generic commander, I'm sad to say. So, can you imagine I rolled the dice?
I'm pretty generic, it's okay.
What? That's hunter shooting.
Swing and a miss.
You know what? It's a demo game, that didn't happen.
Besides which, we're all watching you now. So,
roll it again.
Here we go. So, there's a command symbol. So if you have a command symbol, you could execute that order. When you use it, you take it off the card.
Okay.
At the end of the turn, you can re-roll all your spends.
So at the beginning of the turn,
you roll
those, and then you can use them as you come up. Okay.
So you can mark your target with an attack dice. That allows you, if you're thinking, maybe this guy won't do it, you can add 2 attack dice in.
Yeah.
When it comes to melee, mark your target is criminally powerful, because you're sitting there going, I only got 1 melee dice, I'm going to mark my target, I'm 3 times as tough as I was before. If you're onto the defense, it allows you to imagine if the infantry in the open, imagine they then hunker down.
Mm-hmm.
If you play it twice, if you have 2 shields, I imagine them literally hitting the dirt and crawling towards the enemy.
Yeah.
So you get that one. And then the final one is the command symbol.
Yep.
Command symbol allows you to add 1 to your reaction test. You saw how important reaction was.
Yeah, you can fail to increase your chance.
Thank you so much. I don't want to interrupt you.
No, that's okay. So there you go, Philip. That's it. You learned it all. Have you not got one already?
Nope. I got those last night from you.
Okie dokie. Right, well.
What comes in after the server?
Exactly what we're using here.
Okay.
With the exception of there's another bunker. But we didn't want to put too much on because it gets the table a bit cloudy. But it's everything else. So all of this and these.
Oh, it comes with the terrain bits?
Yeah. Not the trees. But all these little bits and the 2 bunkers. That means that the table, you can play in a little 2x2 straight off the bat and know exactly how to play.
Comes with the ghosts, comes with the hunters, comes with the warlocks.
As well, so you've got the hunters.
Yeah,
I put that in front of that cannon. So you're going to ask me later on anyway, so I might as well put it forward. So there you go, so you get your hunters there.
Yeah.
You get easily my most favourite model in the universe ever.
Yep.
Which is the shiny metallic purple.
How much would you expect a pelican to run?
I think it's like $95 something.
I think it's $95.
It's 75. Yeah, it's 75 pounds.
£75, and the exchange rate killing us right now. I mean, you guys are getting it for like, well, it'll be under a ton anyway. It'll be under about $100. And the 2-player set is running at $95 from War Store at the moment. So that's pretty awesome too. So it's going really well. I mean, this is all that's left.
And then it comes with the rule book.
Yep,
it comes with the rule book. Comes with the rule book.
And also, very importantly, if you were building an army,
yes,
we don't sell codexes, army lists,
anything like that.
What happens is you build your army by saying, "I want to take my officer." Put that down. You say, "Right, what do I need? What else must I take? I must take a basic unit of troops." So there we go. There's my basic unit of troops.
Yep.
What else do I want to add? Well, you know, it's Halo. Your American Express card is, you don't leave home without it, it's got to be a Spartan. And you say, well, and Warhogs, because we all like Warhogs, right? So I'm in. You just add them up, you can see the points there, it'll tell you how many to take, it'll give you a little bit of background, which is quite nice. And then you say, well, I need some optionals now.
Yeah.
Well, I wouldn't mind a little bit of fire support, especially if I'm going up against Derek's Covenant, because I know this kid, he just keeps taking armour all the time.
Yeah.
So I want missile launchers. And then finally, you might want a bit of flexibility, so you say, well, I need the flexibility from an aircraft. Do it.
All right.
You've built your army, got your little calculator and phone by the side, and then when you're done, just flip your cards and you're playing.
And you're going.
So there's no army book.
Yep.
You don't need it. You've just got the cards you would use to play the game in the first place. Where every time we sell you a Scorpion and a Sun Devil, inside that box you'll get 2 cards.
Okay.
One for the Scorpion, one for the Sun Devil.
Yep.
When you want to build a Scorpion,
We give you the model is designed so that we take an earth magnet. You just drop the earth magnet in, glue it in, and then you just take your scorpion turret and go plunk. It's a scorpion.
Yep.
Then you know you're playing Derek, and Derek's just gone and bought himself a couple of Banshees. Down goes the Sun Devil. Why? Because it's an anti-aircraft tank and it will wreck those guys.
Yep.
And that's how it works. So you'll get buy one box, you get double the use of that box.
Yep.
You'll also get your cards that you need to use it, which will tell you how it goes in your army and then how you play it on the table. So in many respects, it allows us to take the weight off ourselves.
Yep.
We don't have to keep bringing out supplements.
Yep.
But we can facilitate.
Just bring out bottles and worry about that, and then you can just add cards.
Exactly. So think of it this way. Nobody really wants to buy a supplement if they can avoid it.
Yeah.
They just want to buy toys.
They want toys.
And that's exactly what we want you to do as well. We want you to buy toys and have fun. Roll your dice. Kill as many stuff as you can. Get excited about that. Know that you're in Halo. The reaction system, I hope you felt that was immersive.
It was good.
You're
no, it was
there.
Good.
There's risk,
it was,
there's reward.
Yes.
Hand of God destroys the Covenant Tower.
It was a bit less clunky than what I've noticed from, like, Infinity, because Infinity has a similar...
Infinity's got an interesting reaction mechanic.
Yes.
It's not the same as ours.
No,
ours is set differently.
It reminds me of that. Yeah. Not similar.
The thing is, Infinity is a skirmish game. It's a very good skirmish game.
It is a good skirmish.
But this is a war game.
Yes.
I think we've nailed it. I think we've got the reaction system in. And reaction system, it's a first-person shooter.
Yep.
First-person shooters are not passive. They're incredibly active.
Yep.
If you're somebody like me who's not very good at them, I'm a frantic button pusher who's hoping that the miracle will happen in a combination of these presses.
Gorgeous stuff.
The truth is it won't, and I'm still rubbish, and I get picked off, and I get noobed all the time. Noob, get off the server, etc., etc. I don't mind, it's fine, it's just a relaxation for me.
Yeah.
But the whole point is that a war game is very difficult to exercise as a first-person shooter.
Yes.
The reaction mechanic is the first
it
step
adds
forward.
That, it adds that bit of instantaneousness.
It also means that if you want to play this game, you don't switch off. You don't get a chance to sit down. You're always in the game.
Yeah.
At the end of a turn, that's the time to go for the toilet, go to the bar, go get the nachos out of the microwave. That's the time to go and get the stuff that you really need. But during the game, no, you're absolutely focused on.
Yeah, and it'll make it seem more fast-paced as opposed to, like, old Warhammer Fantasy that you'd sit down for.
I mean,
that was more strategic.
Yeah, I mean, all these games do what they do.
Oh, absolutely.
And there's loads of fans, and they play those
absolutely.
Games. For me, the reason I like it is because I love Halo.
Well,
can you tell? And I like the fact that we've been able to represent the model so accurately. It does look like what it's supposed to look like. I'm pretty sure Microsoft would not have let us get away with doing half-head measures. It has to look spot on.
Yep.
And then the next step forward is the reaction mechanic and the way the cards are presented.
Yep.
It's just something a bit different. People wouldn't have played this before.
I'm curious. Oh, sorry. I'm curious. Does it come with a scenario book? Because Fleet Battles did. Well, I mean, not the core rule, because Fleet Battles came with the core rules and a scenario book.
It's an interesting one. Because we had an actual place to put the Battle of Reach, we actually had it. We couldn't really recreate the Battle of Reach on the tabletop in terms of the ground command one. What we preferred to do is just allow people to use their imaginations and run with it.
Okay.
Inside the set, you will find a proper list of scenarios.
Yeah, like this is a... this is like what was in with
the reason we've done this like this is because what I want to do is I want to create a competitive set in the book.
Yeah.
But then after that, I want people to be able to use their imaginations and run free with it.
Oh yeah.
Next time around, we'll be releasing scenarios and little mini campaigns online.
Okay.
So just say, getting my mates together, we're going to have a Halo weekend. Cool, you bring your fleet battles, I've got my ground command. Or you all bring your own.
Let's do it.
And sit there and say, right, what are we going to do? Well, this is the latest download they've got. Let's play this out. What have you got? Well, we've not got what we need. Here's the suggested list of ships. So what? We've got a points limit, right? Just add up. We'll get to that.
Yep.
And then you just play out the mission. So in one of the ones that's coming, we've got our a Covenant dastardly plan where they're intending to destroy our planet. The UNFC.
Yeah.
Well, at least that's what it looks like they're trying to do. So they send some Spec Ops people onto a space station and use its guidance system to try and attack the planet, the crash of the planet.
Oh, wow.
The UNFC capture it, get some idea of what's happening, and storm the space station, are repulsed, and then are forced to execute something called the Black Heart Protocol, which is where they use the Mac platforms to destroy the space station.
Okay.
obviously killing everybody on board, including the Covenant, can't make an omelet, etc., etc.
Yeah.
You then spend the time trying to hunt down the Covenant fleet, which escapes into a nebula system.
Yeah.
While this is all happening, the units have been dragged away from what is actually the plan, which was to sneak into the planet and raid a Forerunner vault the humans didn't know were there. And a small force is used, sitting there as garrison, and they realize what's happening and they have to take on the Covenant.
Yeah.
So they fight the Covenant to a standstill, but the Covenant still break through. Everybody dies in the UNSC side.
Of course.
And when the ODST are sent to on the clean up signal, all they find is like a half-eaten Twinkie and an insulting note. And a vault picked clean. So that's basically what we're looking to do, and that's the first scenario. I've just given away the ending now. But
you know, I'm perfectly cool with that. I don't think anyone's...
You're going to read the last scenario, right? That's the way things go.
Yeah.
And that's basically what we want to do, because that's really good. Because then what we've done, now that I've done that one, just go away and do one of your own and send it in to Spartan. And it's good enough. We'll put it in the graphics and we'll put it up.
Yeah. Like I have some ideas for how to do like a full battle of Reach, 300 Covenant ships against something like 150 UNSC, and then how all this scenario would work out to get...
That should be a bloodbath.
Oh, God, yeah.
Give yourself a whole afternoon for that.
Yeah.
The other thing to bear in mind is when you're playing the game, you'll take the... your first game will be a fleet battles game.
Yeah.
The second game is a boarding action game.
Exactly, yeah. And then you transition into the ground command now.
The third game is another fleet action game where the Covenant look like they're running away in the UNSC, try and hunt them down. But it's really just to draw their ships away.
Yep.
And then the final game is the battle for that vault.
Yep.
And then you've got the battles. So you're doing a pendulum style of campaign.
Yeah.
You've got one game and then you've got another, and that means that the game keeps and feels fresh.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah. So once you've got, if you've got a bit more time, maybe we
should
go through a game.
Got the bold bloody game.
The impression that most people want to have a game. So that's
yes, definitely.
And it takes about 15 minutes, and I'll go through principal reaction, which is the next step forward, we reckon, in wargaming. And then we've got the rest of the game and how the saturation system works.
Yeah.
So I'll just set this up very quickly. It's mostly set up because it's a lovely chat. And then we'll kick on again.
That's a pelican, huh?
That's your pelican, mate. You want to touch it? You can't touch it. Remember, that can be set up. You can buy that so it's floating. But there's components in it to allow you to have it landed, the back open, and stick some bits in. So you can make it as a diorama. So if you wanted to make it look impressive on the tabletop as a piece of terrain.
So you can make it either way.
Exactly, yeah. Now, my pelican will almost certainly be landed. I've got the spirit over there. Sorry, the phantom over there. Martin, can you pass me the sheet for the phantom?
That's what the phantom is going to look like?
That is exactly the right scale. So if I put a little dice down, that's how big it is.
That's insane.
Nice. Yeah, I was over at the Spartan Games booth. They're talking about, looking at ways to like attach the vehicles. So they figured out how to do the Warthog, as I recall. They're looking at the Scorpion, if I remember correctly, too. They're still trying to figure out how to attach stuff to the Phantom. I'm looking forward to that.
I don't know if it's sheet, I think we hide in a perspex. Can we have a perspex as well?
Oh, wow.
So it will literally put models in the shade. You can see it creates darkness as it flies. Obviously, you can put that in the flying mode, so it'll come in like this. Or you can have it landed or hovered, just briefly hovered. And we'll come up with some kind of resin support mix for that, so that it'll look like it's hovering, but it's just the resin popping out. And so there, that's your scary phantom. It's pretty awesome, I have to say. It's got me excited.
There's different styles.
That's obviously, these are 50%. That is its length. So I mean, we're talking about possibly under $100 for it. If you think about what other companies charge for resin, that's an absolute steal, as far as I'm concerned. And it'll be up. It'll be that standard. It'll be that quality. It'll look exactly like it should look. We don't need to cut corners because we make the best resin in the world.
It just looks sharp.
Alright, well,
I brought my copy today.
Yeah, see you, man. You happy?
I am. They're holding it for me. Even happier.
Good.
This way I don't have to carry it
around the show yet. Well, I'm glad you got in early because it doesn't look like there's all that much left. This guy did the whole con as well. That's crazy.
airdrop.
Yeah,
you did that last time with the fleets.
Well, fleet battles, although they had, we have four times as much Halo this time as last time. But what's left is what's left, so. So, right, we're looking for,
can I get one of those?
Can you get a
starter set?
Yeah, you can buy it. Just go, we're not selling it. Sorry, I should have made that clear. We're just gaming. I'm just playing stuff. And that's I'm not looking to sell anything. I'm just selling games.
Right,
just grab it from these guys. Oh, Ryan as well. Try and grab a deluxe token set if you can, because the card ones are okay, but I like this.
Yep. Yeah. I'm going to have to pick those up today.
Yeah,
can I get one of those?
Yeah.
Of course you can. You come back with your game and your cards, and I'll give you three of each. Okay, so you looking for a goal?
I'll definitely.
Right.
I played
that. So
you playing again? You come to the foot battles
and then once per game.
Yeah, you don't have an opportunity to recharge. You're just getting clobbered. So, as we can see, we've got our Spartan, our glorious Spartan. He's armed with his assault rifle, which we classify as something called small arms in the game, which is a general catch-all term for armaments that are not special upgrades or one type or another.
Yeah.
Any unit that's got two models on its base is considered to be an upgrade, an upgraded base. In this case, as you can see, it's missile launcher.
Yeah.
Over here, we have our heavy machine gun. One thing to bear in mind about the heavy machine gun is it's got the special rule move or fire. So if you move with it, you will not be able to shoot for any reason that turn. It's a very, very heavy piece of kit, and lifting a jumpy and trying to get in position is not the easiest thing in the world.
Unless you're Spartan.
Unless you're Spartan. Then you'll rip it off its mounting and walk about like it.
Hey, buddy, I just set this up. Come on.
So in the table, what you'll see is you've got two of the standard units, one of the anti-tank units, which as you can see has got two missile launchers, some glorious warthogs, which are armed with the chain gun.
Nice.
And of course, our primo Spartan.
Aye.
Leading the battle force is not the Spartan. Spartans don't lead nothing.
Nope.
This guy's leading the battle force. He's the officer.
Okay.
And he's got his radio operator and his medic too.
Very nice.
All right, guys, I'm down to the last two boxes.
On this side, we have ourselves the Zealot. And we have our Zealot Master. He's basically his bodyguard.
Yep.
He's also the guy who's inevitably going to get hit first.
Oh, of course.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Can't be wasting on the Zealots.
We have our fuel rods.
Yeah.
So our grunts armed with the fuel rods. Enthusiastic, but not necessarily the most devastating things in the world. And of course, the grunts. Hey, very excited to be here.
Yep.
But that's pretty much it.
You get so excited they could die.
You get enough in, you're very strong.
Yeah.
And then finally we have our ghosts. Unless we forget my
beautiful
favorite,
hunters,
the hunter.
I think it is absolutely beautiful.
Obviously, remember, you must take these in twos. Because they are the worm colony separates and they become two of them. And there we have the field in twos. Bear in mind, if you ever kill one of them, the remaining hunter gets furious.
Nice, so they have a berserk
no matter what happens.
I love that.
Why are you shooting?
Oh, sure. I hate it in the games, but I love it here.
Which side would you like to play?
I'll play UNSC.
Okay, right.
I'm used to losing.
Stick with the Covenant. I'll go through a process of showing you how reaction works.
All right.
As I was saying, first-person shooters are not massive engagements.
Yeah.
You're frenetic. You're pressing buttons madly, trying desperately to do damage. You can't really. It's very difficult to do that on a tabletop because inevitably most tabletops are an I go, you go system. Or perhaps to paraphrase it more accurately, I go, you do nothing and take off your model system. Then you can go and I'll take off my model system. If it's a turn by turn system, you're more likely to take off more of your models and then you hopefully get a chance to go again. In this case, we have a reaction system.
All
so I'm going to nominate this unit and you would be able to say, Derek, I intend to react.
All right.
You can react at the beginning of my move or at the end of my move. If you're going to react at the end of my move, don't say anything. Wait. So let's have a go over here. I'm going to act at this unit and I'm going to move them up here.
Anytime a unit of infantry gets wounded,
so they move to six. Then you would say to me, Derek, I intend to try and react.
All right, I intend to try and react.
By looking at the card.
Minus one, because there's a bad.
There's a card here.
Okay.
And you'll see two numbers. The first number is a number that you're trying to roll or exceed on 2d6 if the unit does not have an activation marker, and that is the case in this instance.
Okay.
To roll the 9 if they do. In this case, you're just looking for 7.
Alright.
And he's nailed it for 10. Right.
Nice.
Okay, so that means that you get to say, hold on, Derek, I'm bucking you here, I'm going to fire. So let's work out how many dice we're going to need.
Alright.
The weapons are separated into AP, that's attack,
anti-personnel, AT anti-tank, and AA anti-aircraft. Right. In this case, each one of these stands is rolling three dice. So I will grab three for each one of those. One, two, three. And if you would look to tell me how many does the heavy machine gun get?
Six.
One, two. So you're going to have to put your camera down and cut these.
Okay.
There we go.
See if I can roll. Oh, bombs.
There we go.
So line of sight now. He can't see anyone.
Rolling better than I did on my last fleet battles.
So, we'll get rid of the skulls. And because I'm behind hard cover, we'll get rid of these as well.
Sure. Right. Yeah, go for it.
And then these twos turn down to being ones.
Alright.
Yeah.
Now, I then have to look at my cards and tell you, well, here's my grunt levy. They're not blessed with the toughest of body armor, so I need two hits to hurt a glunt levy. So I place two next to him.
Right.
And of course, two next to him. And two next to him. And then there's three placed next to him. So you only needed two hits, so I have to take off these guys. Ripped apart by the machine gun.
Unfortunately, my camera died right here, so you don't get to see the rest of the battle, but I'll give you the gist of what happened. So after I wiped out his grunts, his remaining elite moved into the base capturing it, essentially, which is the ultimate goal of the scenario. The following turn, I decided to move these guys forward to try and, you know, take on the enemy directly. That obviously did not go very well. It's human forces against plasma. The turn after that, he used his elite to try and take out some of my machine gun forces that had originally wiped out his grunt squad. For the last turn, though, I got to use the Spartan, and boy is it awesome in ground command. I literally got to take this Spartan and charge right into the base, beating the shit out of the Sungheili and his grunt back up there, and taking the base, ultimately winning. It was a very small scenario, not a whole lot going on, just kind of there to show the basic mechanics and whatnot. If you've played fleet battles, the mechanics carry over pretty well. They're very similar in a lot of regards, but there's some nice stuff that kind of rebalances the gameplay so it works better on the ground, essentially. So, I hope you enjoyed this. Let me know. I definitely want to do more stuff like this in the future when I can try and get exclusives. Hopefully I can get a better camera going forward with better audio equipment, but for now, this has been Halo Canon. Thanks for watching. Be sure to give a like and consider subscribing and sharing this video around. Also consider checking out Gamefly, with over 8,000 new releases and classic games for current and previous gen consoles, and even some older consoles. Gamefly is a great way to try tons of games without buying them. Go to gameflyoffer.com/halocanon to start your 30-day free trial.